You want to go, Jay?
No, let him talk.
Number one, boy.
Wait, are you saying, I mean, you came out here more animated than we've ever seen you, more focused than we've ever seen you, and you're crediting it to the fact that the death of your mother just what? Focused your mind what?
I was already focused, you know.
Well, what surprised you from the get-go? What were you going to try to do from the get-go?
That's what I did, whip his ass. You know, I mean, you come to fight, I come to fight. I told you in the room, I said, but it was time for James Ellis to come out of the closet.
But it seems you had
You know, I told you that I also had times where I had great fights that would come back with two or three different fights that was mediocre, you know, and I would leave a lot of doubt. I don't blame you guys. You guys go on what you see, you understand? But I know, and my people know, that
he
was the real James Ellis is all about.
Every challenger for Mike Tyson says the same thing, but you did something in there.
I told you. I told
to
you
neutralize him.
Why my nose? Thank you, Jesus.
All right, just one moment. But
I told you in the room. I said,
but
they weren't James Douglas.
But you didn't let him get off. It seemed every time he wanted to throw a punch, either you beat him to it or you smothered him. Was that the idea?
Well, I just did what I did, you know. I went out there and fought my fight.
All right.
Yeah, very instinctive, very instinctive.
All right, now you had him, but you get knocked down at the end.
Well, yeah, you know, and that was a good shot. I mean, you know, like I said before, a man over 200 pounds has a good shot.
Did you get careless? Did you think you had him?
I think so. That was just starting to get real relaxed, you know, and I got shook. I mean, well, I got hit, and I came back, you know, sucked it up. Because I knew I had him also. You know, I knew he was, every time he would try to get off, I would come back, you know, and offset him by beating him to his punch. You know, because Mike, well, early in the fight, you know, Mike would come out, you know, and throw his big shot. You know, so what I would do is just, you know, go with him and come back with my own. You know, and another thing, I was very relaxed. I wasn't afraid of the man. I feared no man. Because I believe in God. That's the only man I fear. You know, thank God. I give this praise to the Lord Jesus Christ.
But you know that you're in there with Mike Tyson after the knockdown. Did you think he would come on, or did you know you had to stop his momentum at that point?
Well, yeah, I knew he was going to come because he's a champion. I mean, he's going to suck it up and come and get me, you know? And I was ready for it. I was aware of everything, you know, totally aware of everything. And, Dad, this one is for you. I love you.
Wait, could you see the confusion in his eyes? One of his eyes was closed.
Well, I seen that early on, you know, because of the stiff jab. You know, I was just letting him run into the jab because, you know, speed, I have tremendous speed. I have tremendous ability. As I told you earlier in the room, I said, well, you know, I'm conditioned to go 12 rounds. And that's what I was conditioned for. That's why I was able to get up from the knockdown. You know, it was a good shot. You know, I give him all respect for that. You know, but when I got up, it was like, well, it's time to go ahead and get him out of there.
You hit him with
I got careless. I got careless, Larry. You know, I started, you know, getting in control of everything. And then all of a sudden, he caught me with a good shot.
He took some fearsome punches.
This is a dream, man. This is truly a dream. I swear to God. This is a dream. This is a dream, man. Put the belt on.
Put it on.
This is truly a dream, man. I watched your HBO 1,000 times putting belts on guys or, you know, interviewing guys, and I said one day it's going to be me. One day it's going to be me, and thank God that it was me today.
You hit him with some fearsome punches.
I hit him with some great shots.
Well, that's great.
Because, you understand, like my dad said, you know, you hit him with shots, let him take it. Like, oh, okay. You want to take a shot. Yeah, be a tough guy. Just keep chopping on him. And eventually he's going to go. And that's what happened. As you seen over there, he was flat on his ass.
That's right. Yeah.
I think that tells the whole story, Jim. Mike Tyson, flat on his whatever you want to call it. Jim.
Rodney, I love you, Rodney.
James Buster Douglas, 29 years old, Columbus, Ohio, undisputed heavyweight champion of the world. Well, if you're a...